us. We've got the paper review coming up.
Come on, gang.
Come on, it's the Weather Gang.
Introducing the Weather Gang. Simon. Ben. Oh, they've gone around the other way. We've got about them all running through. It would have been marvellous.
Oh, it's very cold out there this morning.
Is it?
It's quite damp.
Not that cold. Do you know, like an ear of cry, finding your heart. Oh, you must be Denise. I love doing that in shops.
What, because I've got my name necklace on?
Yes, you can help me, Eloise. OK, here we go. Here's the independent which Donna's holding, not her paper of choice, but fair.
No, I'm more an observer.
Yeah, she's, you like the observer, but it's not a daily, is it?
Vote.
That's a daily. It's time to consign Thatcher to history. Blair abandons his previous attempts to portray himself as Thatcher's natural hair. Sorry, air, as he highlights her shortcomings. There we go. It's funny, since he took charge, we've had nothing but bad luck in this country, have we? Mm. Floods and stuff. OK. I don't know, maybe the Tories were right with that poster, you know, and the eyes and everything. You know, I was suddenly thinking about it. You've got country suddenly run by farmers and truckers. If I wanted that, I'd have moved to France. Let's go over to the mail. Filthy wards killing 5,000 people a year. Getting another big New Labour initiative there. Getting the, I'll gather classrooms are more overcrowded than ever before as well. Another great Labour initiative. Maybe the Tories had it right. No, here we go. Costing the... OK, I'm going to go to the Sun.
Sunny's perked up.
Rovers. Well, it just turns out Sunny was a young Tory.
Conservative.
Seriously.
Not true.
Sunnygate, Sunnygate, now in its second day.
It's a lie. It's a lie.
Tory
it's
boy, not. Tory boy.
Tory boy. I'd sooner top myself.
Seriously. Seriously, Dr. Fox came up to me and in good faith told me. Now, Foxy, how did you come about this superb bit of intelligence?
Because I know a friend of his from many years ago, of course, has information.
This is the sound. Do you know what I'm loving? I'm loving about everyone in the sound department. They started turning
they
on
really
themselves.
They started just... They just really bicker
They started
themselves.
Just to loathe each other. But Sonny and Foxy stuck in a lift. That's a show right there. And also, I'd say happy birthday to Kelly Brook, who's 21 today.
Yes,
today.
And good luck
tonight, the opening of the play. If unfortunately, I sleep. If I can get the kid to sleep, if I can find a babysitter, if I can get an afternoon nap. Yeah, not quite the kind of babysitter I had in mind there.
Hey, there's a party around Johnny's. You're all invited.
But anyway, best luck tonight, and I hope to be able to make that. Do you know what? I'm going to get in there later. Okay, first of all, car crazy. Jim Greaves' marriage is on Skid Row because you know why? No. Go on, have a guess.
He loves cars.
He loves cars. What sort of car? Vintage cars. Oh, you read the paper. No, it's not. It's Volkswagen Beetles. Volkswagen, people's wagon. The 69-year-old dad of two has 10 of the prized old bangers cluttering up his drive, but now wife, Norma, 63. It's kind of died out as a name, that, hasn't it?
Norma, yeah, spring it back.
You very rarely see a baby. What are you calling her? We're going to call her Norma.
If you give
She's
birth
got a brother
today,
called Alan.
If you give birth today to a small little girl,
yes,
call her Norma.
Yes, that'd be lovely.
Yeah.
And told the retired physicist, I'll divorce you if you get one more. So that's what the wife said. She said, if you get one more Volkswagen Beetle, I'll divorce you. Norma insists he thinks more of his damn cars than he does me. He spends hours each day fiddling with them. She says, you never buff my headlamps like that. She says, how about jacking me up for a service once in a while? She says, perhaps, I don't know, is that a bit strong? Perhaps my parts would work a bit better if they got the occasional squirt of WD-40. Still car-related vaguely, isn't it? Anyway, Norma said, also said, and although I'm still here, he's really pushing his luck now. She said she'd leave him at 8. He's got 2 more. And she hasn't left.
Maybe
he's thinking, what am I going
to
do?
Exactly,
like, just pull up with a car transporter, just full on. And Bob's like, are you going to leave me now?
You'd think she'd get the message, wouldn't you?
Yes, you'd think that, wouldn't you, Dan? Yeah. Shove off! Norma. Radio scandal. The army is still waiting for a new combat radio system. Probably part of our new Labour's running the services down. 12 years after it was ordered. And Whitehall spending watchdogs yesterday warned it could take another 3 years. Troops were forced to use mobile phones in combat zones in places like Kosovo. The old daddy, you'd sort of there and suddenly you get that. What's that awful tune I hate? No, the tune I hate is But anyway, that rings. Pick it up. Hello? All right, Colonel, yeah. Yeah, we're advancing now. Yeah, I'll speak to you later, mate. Down it goes. Rings back a little bit later. Pick it up. You're in combat. You have a message waiting. You press your 1-2-1 or whatever, he goes, RETREAT! You know? Comes there. An armed robber took a woman hostage during a post office raid, was fought off by a 77-year-old war vet. Yeah! He went in, the 77-year-old war veteran. He went in to find the man holding a gun to the head of a lone customer. Wow. So the guy's at the counter demanding money with a lone customer.
Right, you don't have to reenact it on me.
No, I'm not trying to give viewers ideas. And it says here, while staff are refusing to hand over the money. Oh, yeah, they're all nice, aren't they? Behind bulletproof glass, arms crossed like that. Mm. Yeah, give me the money. Go, you do what you like, mate, because we're behind here, we're nice and safe. Yeah. Don't care. The pensioner jumped on the raider.
Yes.
Good lad, and dragged him to the floor. The man fought back and fled empty-handed. The pensioner, former Merchant Navy seaman, said he got more than he bargained for. He didn't get any cash, but he got billed for me. Veteran con man, aged 82. I'm just thinking, at what age does a career criminal, probably haven't done anything serious and hurt someone and stuff like that, what age does a career criminal become quite lovable? I would say at the age of 83. A veteran con man, aged 83, swindled a woman out of £2,500 by posing as a Second World War hero. Oh. But this is what I love, the fact he's not only he's called Charlie. But he's also got silver hair.
Silver!
Hello there. I'm a con man. Silver-haired Charlie Cowden, who has 571 convictions.
No!
Well, you know what I mean? There comes up, well, you'll see what happens, and you see the judge even sort of cops the fact he's a good lad, really.
Minor convictions.
Minor convictions. No, nothing serious, no. Well, I don't know. He's had 571. Might be a couple of serious ones in there for a win. I don't know. Perhaps we should be cheering, and perhaps I'm being really irresponsible live on television. Pretended to be J.P. Keneally, a real colonel, awarded the Victoria Cross for Distinguished Service. He even had a full set of fake medals. Hello there. I'm a con man. Hello there, heroic con man.
Probably those chocolate coins.
But he had, some of his form, and this is a must for any good 83-year-old silver-haired con man. You've got to have a bigamy charge, haven't you? You've got to have been married twice at the same time. You've got to have it. It's on one of the boxes. You've got a cross under silver-haired con man. You know, he just got snookered. He's thinking, God, I've got myself in the right old hero. Well, I'll just marry her and just clear off on the honeymoon, I think. Anyway, his form includes a conviction for bigamy, and he served hard labour in, needless to say, he didn't fight in the war. He wasn't he says he's idling on War Department land he was charged with. But this is the mark of it. Judge Timothy King called him a thorough rogue. The word rogue means no one minds being called a rogue. No. You're a young rogue.
You lovable rogue.
No, cad bounder. It's a rogue. I think the word lovable is always
rogue.
No, it is. You just have to say rogue, and we know lovable.
Yeah.
Ooh, you're rogue.
Yeah. That's
all the judges said. You're a rogue, sir. You with your 571 convictions.
Johnny, you've just got crud there.
All right. Is it gone now?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I love my fiancé very much, and we're getting married on January the 10th.
Aww.
She writes to Jane O'Gorman, who solves your love problems only in the Star. It's only going to be a small do, but she's insisting on inviting her disgusting grandmother to the event. She makes Albert's steptoe look attractive. She's unwashed, passes wind in public, has the most disgusting table manners, and she makes me ill when she eats. Grey Army!
Grey Army! Grey Army!
Grey Army! What do we love?
Biscuits!
When do we love them?
Yeah!
What do they dip in their tea?
Biscuits!
What clacks against their false teeth? Mints!
Barley sugar.
My mum is jealous of me because it's 8:18 and I should have finished hours ago. Right, do you know what? I can do the fun down with the pun down, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. Just quickly, Goldie Hawn's had a lap dancing pole put in her bedroom.
Has she?
Good lass. And I'm not saying Guinness Book of Records is dumbing down, but a guy is in the Guinness Book of Records for juggling lit candles on his moustache.
What?
It seems to me, look, I've got a record now, the most grape in an eye. Do I qualify? I just improvised that, you'll understand, it wasn't in the script. Yeah. Okay. Was it all right? Am I a record breaker? Oh, it turns out I am a record breaker. God, I'm now gonna smash my UK record. Thank you very much. I don't know, it's just something you've either got a flair for or you haven't, yeah. Son, Argos workers. Argos, they should turn them into pubs. So, fellas, can you just sit around and drink, wait for your stuff, pick them from the catalogue, have a nice day's drinking, walk out with all your presents all nicely wrapped. They're missing a trick. Argos for men. Argos workers.
Brighter drinking, brighter shopping.
Exactly right. Exactly right. Brighter drinking, wet your bed. Argos workers hire strippers to raise money for children in need. Pun sex. Putty Bear. Dude, son, EastEnders stars are annoyed they can't go to an audience with Ricky Martin because it's on ITV.
No, they've been banned.
An audience with Ricky Martin? Is he a bit of a wit then, is he?
I'm going to that.
Are you? But is he a wit? Is Ricky a wit?
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah. No, is he? Does he tell like Latin gags and stuff?
He's a rat.
No, he's singing. I don't mean like he's as singing. In.
Vini, vidi, vici.
He's okay. Singing.
What?
He's singing.
Oh, right, but that's it, no gags.
Well, no, I don't think so. I mean,
what's the point? That's just a gig, isn't it? Yeah. It's not an audience
with.
It's just a gig.
He's chatted to the audience.
He can barely speak English.
He can!
No, he's Ricky Martin and he. No. No, he's like he is.
Lovely.
He said, I'm very good on his side. I never done. This town like a great big chicken. Just swear to get plucked. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna cut on the side. Make way for the bad guy, Ricky Martin, eh? Okay, here we go.
That's
the pun
really
says,
good.
It's a good pun. The pun says, leave it, la prima choca, eh? Now the leg, huh? Okay, here we go. Son, Kelly Brook appears topless for her theatrical debut. This is a great pun. The pun says, Act One, Scene Two. Yay! Those were the people's puns, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, what have we got now, Den?
Okay,
I think after the break,
we've got that death-defying stunt.
Oh, death-defying stunt.
On a motorcycle.
Is he back in still practicing? We're going to really build to that. That's really important.
There,
Pete, are you confident?
He'll do it. He'll do it. Easy. Yeah. He says.
Okay, nice. Fingers crossed, everyone.
It's absolutely
okay,
live.
Okay, and that's absolutely live. Back in a couple of seconds. Do not go away. This is a big breakfast.
Yes!